Not really. It's just a matter of understanding B. Smith. She didn't get to be top dog just by looking after number one.
So, you're free to go now, Mrs. Brooks.
Thank you for dropping the charges, Sergeant.
I didn't have much choice, did I, after Smith's statement? In my opinion, you're guilty.
Excuse me.
B, thank you.
Can it, will you? Like I said, the mercy release was a long shot anyway.
Bye.
Well, that's very interesting.
What?
One minute you're telling the court you're scared of her, the next minute you're all out.
She's still my friend.
Yeah, I'll bet she is.
Just what are you implying?
You didn't pull the wool over my eyes. You're as guilty as Smith.
You decided to drop the charges against Mrs. Brooks. She was acquitted. Now, are you pressing new charges or just harassing her?
Thank you, Mrs. Morris. Well, I better be going.
I'll drive you home.
Thank you. I'd rather walk. I've got a lot of thinking to do.
Well, what could I do but tell the truth? I told them they thought that Gaffney testified out of spite and that her testimony against Smith was a pack of lies.
I see. It's going to cause problems, isn't it?
What, you think that Smith's cronies might be out after Gaffney's blood?
Yes, which eventually will lead to a power struggle.
No, I'm not so sure. I think they're too worried about Smith to cause any trouble.
I hope you're right.
Who are you worried about, Smith or Gaffney?
Both. Mainly because of the work I've put in on the Needs Committee. I spoke to Bryant about it some time ago. Not that I think we have much chance of getting it off the ground now.
Oh, come on, you're being a bit pessimistic, aren't you?
With Gaffney as top dog? Mm. At least Smith would have given this project some sort of chance. I get the impression that Gaffney won't even consider it.
Hi.
Look, not here, Terry.
All right, where?
Look, we're on duty.
Oh, yes, Miss Bennet.
Don't make fun of me. I'm trying to change, but...
Hey, don't you dare change. If it wasn't for you, we wouldn't have tame criminals like Gaffney. A few more like her around here, and this place will run like clockwork.
Yes, Jim Fletcher doesn't agree with you.
Oh, come on, love, he's just as anxious as we are.
He went against Gaffney's evidence at Smith's trial.
What? I don't believe it.
It's true.
What, did Gaffney tell him the truth in the first place?
Of course she did. Smith's been faking all along.
Well, Wiseman doesn't think so. I mean, a man like him with his years of experience...
Experience? What experience has he had in the day-to-day running of a prison? None. A few weeks' duty in here, and he wouldn't be taken in so easily. I'm better qualified to comment on the way these women react.
Hey, I didn't say you weren't. Hey, look, I tell you what, I'll pick you up about 7:30 and we're going to have some seafood, eh? You like that?
Yes, that'll be lovely.
Good, fine. I'll see you later.
All right, ladies, come on, buy up.
Oh, about bloody time, too. I'm on my last fag.
Come on, Dobbs, we haven't got all day.
And don't smoke them all at once. Remember, half to me, all of yous.
One of these days, you're going to go too far.
Is that a fact?
You better believe it. If what you said in court stops B from getting treatment, I'm going to go you.
Pacemaker or no pacemaker.
You bet on it, girl.
All right, come on, break it up. That means you too, Bryant.
You heard any news, Mr. Fletcher?
About what?
About me transfer.
First I've heard of it.
Beatrice Ellis Smith. You have been found guilty of escaping from legal custody. And your sentence is 18 months to be served concurrently with your present sentence. Is that correct?
Yes.
Thanks, Constable. Seems the court didn't take your amnesia into consideration. Well, there must be some reason for that.
Smith?
Oh, hello, Mrs. Davidson. Heard the latest?
Yes, Mrs. Morris phoned. When did you get your memory back?
Just between you and me?
Just between us.
When I was shoved in that storeroom, something clicked. Reminded me of being in the tunnel. Seems funny, doesn't it, an old lag like me getting claustrophobia after all the time I've been locked up?
I'd like to say that what you did was rather courageous. I'm sure Mum thinks so too.
Yeah, well, doesn't matter anymore, does it? It's all over.
Well, you'd better go and have your shower now. You'd better keep a close eye on Smith and Gaffney.
Are you expecting trouble?
Well, Smith's not likely to take kindly to Gaffney informing on her, is she?
Miss Stokes. What are you hanging around for, Gaffney? You've got yours.
Just keeping the troops in order.
What about our deal?
What deal?
You know damn well. Oh, testifying against Smith.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, it didn't do much good, did it?
Well, it wasn't my fault. It was bloody Fletcher.
When's my transfer coming?
It's not.
We had a deal.
Officers don't make deals with prisoners, Gaffney. You've been here long enough to know that.
Bags, Dumbo, and quick. I said half.
Don't do it. I'm warning you, Margot.
You and whose army? I'll be!
Oh, come on, Smith. You're blocking up the doorway.
Jeez, B, what happened?
Shut up, door. What's happening?
She's back. She's really back.
No, you bloody bitch! You set me up!
All right, what's going on?
It's all right, Mr. Harrison. Nice try, Gaffney. But why should I send you to solitary? I'm sure Smith can teach you how to talk to an officer.
What were you and Gaffney talking about?
Nothing much.
Well, knowing her and seeing the look on her face, it couldn't have been very pleasant.
Just the usual name-calling. Best to ignore it.
That doesn't sound like the Vera I know. You could have put her in the pounds, you know.
No need for that. They'll sort it out themselves.
You're really enjoying this, aren't you?
Why should I?
So even though Gaffney's evidence didn't do me any damage, we all know how I feel about lagging, don't we, girls?
Too right.
Don't we, Lil and Bev?
Yeah, right.
But that means you let her bash me.
Look, I'm sorry about that, love. I did warn her off in private, but, well, there's nothing else I could do.
Oh, yeah, thanks a million.
I said I was sorry. If I stood up for you, but the screws were almost onto me as it was.
Yeah, I suppose. Still was hard on door. You could have told your old mates.
The less people who knew about it, the better chance I had of getting away with it.
Yeah, well, you didn't have to tell Margot for crying out loud.
I know that wasn't the smartest thing in the world, but she got up my nose. As a matter of fact, she still does.
Now, what are you going to do to her?
Have a look at her. She's on the run already. I think I'll let her sweat. Then when she starts to relax...
Something worrying you, Gaffney?
I want to go to my cell.
Don't you like the company?
Come on, Gaffney.
You had a lot to say to Miss Bennett.
So?
What was it about?
Said she was a rotten mongrel, so
watch your mouth, Gaffney. You'd be up on a charge.
She had it coming. She piped on me.
What are you talking about?
You know the deal I made with Vinegar. You were there.
Miss Bennett, if you don't mind.
Oh, who the hell cares? She said she wasn't going to get me transfer. Said that screws don't do no deals with prisoners.
Now, wait a minute. Are you sure that's what she meant? That she wouldn't try and get you a transfer?
Of course I'm sure. And you know what that means, don't you? B won't stop until she gets me now. She's practically signed a death warrant.
Home, darling.
Hello, love.
How things got caught?
Oh, the charges against Mum were dropped.
Well, that sounds like good news. Why the long face? Drink?
What? Oh, yes, thanks.
Did you manage to get in touch with Nick Clark?
No. I tried, but he wasn't at home. I left a message.
Well, you can forget about it till tomorrow, then. Huh?
Can I forget about it?
Yes. Cheers.
How was your day?
Oh, not too bad. It's good to be home, though. Darling, you're home. Relax. Forget about Mum, the office, Nick Clark, all of them.
Wish I could.
What you need is a holiday.
Oh, fat chance I've got of getting one.
Well, you must have some leave, do you? We haven't had a few days for the honeymoon. I could take a week or two off and we could go away somewhere, just lie in the sun, relax and enjoy ourselves. How about that?
Sounds marvellous, but I wouldn't be able to relax.
Of course you would.
No, I wouldn't, honestly. I couldn't leave Nick now. I just feel as though I'd run out on him. I'd be one more person who'd let him down. Darling, I'm sorry. Let's just drop the subject, eh? For tonight, anyway.
Okay. Cheers.
Thank you.
You were very quiet on the way home. Is something the matter?